Hey, Brandon from Poindexter here with another exhilarating episode of How to Create Financial Projections, this time for a two-sided marketplace. This example is a little different than the others we've covered so far in that the marketplace model has more than one target user base, which makes our task all the more challenging. So we'll just dive right in to illustrate how it works. We'll start by naming our project, which we'll call Airbnb for Uber, and it'll be a marketplace where people can find unused Ubers to sleep in. In this example, one side of the market is known as the buyers, and these are the people looking for a place to sleep for the evening. On the other side of the market, we have our target sellers, and these are the owners of the Uber vehicles that are willing to rent them out to people that are looking for a place to sleep. We'll start by forecasting our seller's market, which will provide the inventory of Ubers available for users to book. One of the first ways I'll acquire sellers is by telling my driver about the app each time I ride in an Uber. I'll take a series of short trips just to spread the word, and based on a budget of $100 a month and an average price of $5 per ride, we can expect to generate 20 leads on average. Next, we'll set the conversion rate for drivers that actually sign up for the app. I'm sure most Uber drivers are going to jump at the chance to let random strangers sleep in their car, so we'll set the conversion rate to 75%. The second way we'll attract sellers will be through paid advertising on billboards along popular Uber routes, where we'll spend about $10,000 a month and generate 50,000 leads. We expect 50% of these leads to follow up and visit our website, and then 60% of them will continue onward and sign up for our app. We'll be optimizing our landing page for signups, so we'll also assume our conversion rate will increase by 5% per month over the next 12 months. Now that we have our sellers, we can take a look at how we'll attract the buyers. We've been building relationships with travel bloggers over the past few months, so we're primed and ready to do some guest blog posts targeted at people looking for a place to stay in the LA area. Out of a total of one guest post per month over the next year, we can expect 20,000 leads per article. About 10% or so of these leads should click through to our site, and 50% of them will go on to download the app and become our customers. Okay, so we're now ready to go on and set up our revenue models. The key thing to think about here is how either side of our two-sided market drives revenue. For instance, if we're charging a transaction fee, it'll make sense to forecast revenue based on the users that are actually making transactions. Alternatively, if we're charging users each time they list a new product, we'll want to make sure that we apply that revenue to the appropriate side of our market. This is where being organized with our customer acquisition channels will come in handy. Another consideration with the marketplace model is that typically one side of the market is subsidized so we can amass a large number of either buyers or sellers, whichever we need in greater quantity. For us, we'll be subsidizing the buyers, so it will be free for them to sign up and use the app, but once they book a car to sleep in, we'll take a cut of the purchase price. The first thing we'll do is give this revenue stream a name, and check out our customer sources to make sure we don't include any sellers in this calculation. Next, there are two ways we can set up a revenue model. The first is charging a flat fee every time a user books a car. In this case, all we need to do is set the flat fee in the price field. The second method is by charging a percentage of the overall transaction, which is the method we'll use here. Assuming an average rate of $100 a night, and based on a transaction fee of 3%, we can expect $3 per booking. If we expect users to book multiple nights per month because, for instance, we help them realize how cool it is sleeping in cars, we can then set that expectation in the number of purchases field to account for that increased level of usage. So we'll set it at an average of 3 nights or transactions per month. Lastly, since users are no doubt going to love this experience, we'll say that an average of 10% of our user base will return to the app each month. This revenue stream is now ready to go, but if you expect different tiers in purchase sizes, we'd want to set up an additional revenue stream for each level of purchase that we expect users to make. For instance, the $100 per night rental rate might be good to book a small sedan, but the rate for a large SUV could be something like $200 per night, which would mean an average fee of $6 per transaction, based on our 3% transaction fee. So it's important to consider the purchase size as a factor. Another method to forecast revenue from transaction fees is by calculating the gross merchandise volume. This method is more commonly used in e-commerce, but I want to cover it because many marketplaces include the sale of products. We'll set up the revenue model the same way we just did, but the only difference here is that instead of inputting our transaction fee in the price field, we'll input the entire purchase amount. After we click Save, the next thing we'll need to do is go over to the Costs page. We'll then select the percentage of sales model and input the seller's cut as a percentage of the revenue. Since we're collecting 3% of each transaction, that means the seller gets the other 97%, which is what we'll want to input in the expense as a percentage of sales field. Just make sure we're applying the expense to the right revenue stream and categorize this cost as a cost of revenue, and then we're all set. Now we'll move on to the sellers. We'll be charging $5 per month to list their vehicles in our system, so we'll use the subscription model to forecast this revenue. We'll start by making sure our customer channels are set up correctly and that no buyers are included in this payment option. And assume that 75% of potential sellers that signed up will actually list their vehicle available for rent. Now we can just set the price to $5 per month and include some churn because, and I know this is going to be very hard to believe, but the app won't be ideal for everyone, so we'll set it to 10%. Then we just click Save, and we've now successfully forecast our revenue from both sides of the market. From here, we can go on to include our expected cost to finish out our projections. Poindexter has 7 pre-built cost models to allow for maximum flexibility in setting up your cost structure. We're not going to go into the details of each cost model right now, since it's going to be different for each business, but whether you want to set up your costs on a per transaction basis, as a percentage of sales, per user, or even simple recurring or fixed costs, we have you covered. We'll create another video in the future that covers how to think about using each of these cost models so you can apply it to your own situation. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on forecasting revenue for marketplace business models. If you have any suggestions for more videos or questions on the one you just watched, be sure to leave a comment below and we'll get back to you as quickly as we can. That'll do it for now, and as always, good luck planning the success of your business.